Okay, dear students, today I'll discuss one more thing, stoichiometry of reactions in solution. Yesterday we have talked the same kind of solution mixed with one another having different molarity, different volume, and when it is getting mixed together, then the overall molarity changes. Now today I'll discuss that we will mix two different solutions with one another, which can react with one another, like sodium hydroxide and hydrochloric acid. Sodium hydroxide solution and hydrochloric acid solution can mix with one another. When we mix these two solutions together, there will be reaction and it will give the some product. So it will give you the sodium chloride and hydrogen gas, there will be neutralization reaction. So in the same, so if a such kind of solution we are mixing with one another, then we can find out the molarity and amount of one of the reactant in comparison to the another reactant. So for that we have taken an example, like we have taken a reactant A and reactant B. These two are made to react with one another to form a product like C and D. So when C and D is formed, so X mole of A reacts with Y mole of B to produce the P mole of C and Q mole of D. So these two reacts and these two products are formed. Now we have taken the volume of this A, V1, and the volume of B, that means V1 ml, suppose we have taken, and V2 ml of B was taken. Molarity of reactant A is M1, molarity of reactant B is M2. So the total number of moles of A would be M1, B1. Yesterday we have explained it, that how it is M1, B1. In the previous video lecture, you might have find that how does, when these two multiply together, we get the total number of moles of this reactant, and M2, V2 would be the total number of moles of reactant B. Now, according to the equation, number of moles of A is X and number of moles of B is Y. M1, B1 is a number of moles of A. We have got it through calculation, and X mole we have got it by balancing the chemical equation. So this X mole and this M1 B1 both are representing the same reactant, both are representing the number of moles of the same reactant. So that's why these two are equal to one another. That's why I have written X equal to M1 B1. In the same way, M2 B2 is the number of moles of B, and Y is also a number of moles of B. So this Y and this M2 B2 will be equal to one another because both are the number of moles of the same reactant participated in chemical reaction. So that's why I write Y equal to M2 B2. So X mole equal to M1 B1 mole, Y2 equal to M2 B2 mole. So this is the total number of moles. Okay. Now take this X this side. So it will be 1 equal to M1 B1 by X. If you take Y this side, then it will be 1 equal to M2 V2 by Y. Now both are 1. This one 1, this one is also 1. So 1 is equal. So that means this and this will be equal to one another. That's why finally we are getting M1 V1 by X equal to M2 V2 by X. So product of the molarity and volume divided by their number of moles would be equal to the reactant of the reactant in the same. So when the different reactant, when the different reactants participates in the same reaction and get completely used up, in that case the ratio of the mass into volume by coefficient will be equal to one another. Mass into volume by coefficient, number of moles into volume by coefficient, number of moles into volume by coefficient, both are equal. Even if we have got the threefold, reactant. In that case also we can have the equivalent number like this. So number of moles into volume divided by coefficient equal to number of moles, number of mole divided by coefficient. So molarity into volume by coefficient, molarity into volume by coefficient. So this is the formula to calculate the number of moles, any amount of reactant, to find out the amount of reactant present in a reaction. When the two solutions are made to react with one another, then we have to find out how much reactant used up in this reaction. If the amount of one of the reactant is given, then you can find out the amount of other reactants through this reaction. If the strength of the solution is given, we can find out the amount of the reactant present in the reaction. Okay, this is the case. So we have discussed like this. So we have got a two different type of mixture. A mixture in which two same kind of solutions are made, mixed with one another, having different molarity and volume, which we have discussed yesterday. In that case we have got a equation. Now today I have discussed the two different kind of chemicals are mixed together. That means first of all we prepare the aqueous solution of two different chemicals which might react with one another, like sodium hydroxide and hydrochloric acid. Take the solution of sodium hydroxide, take the solution of hydrochloric acid of any molarity. Both will have different molarity, both will have different volume, but when mixed it together, it will react and forms the two product. Now, if the strength of the sodium hydroxide is given, then we can find out the strength of the hydrochloric acid. So during the titration, this formula is utilized. During the volumetric analysis, this relation will be utilized. Okay. Now we'll discuss the molality. So molality is very simple. Again, it is a number of moles of the solute present in 1000 gram. Present in 1000 gram or 1 kg of solvent. Here we have number of moles are compared with mass of the solvent, not with the solution. So that is why mathematically molality can be represented like this. Molality is always indicated or has got a symbol by small m. So formula would be the number of moles of the solute by number of kg of the solvent. Now what would be the number of moles of the solute? Number of moles of the solute. What is the number of moles of the solute? Actual mass of the solute divided by molar mass of the solute will give you the number of moles of the solute. So this is same formula I have written here. So it is replaced by its formula. Again, it will be replaced by its formula. Mass of the solvent in gram. Mass of the solvent in gram divided by 1000. It will become kg. Gram divided by 1000. Becomes kg. So it is written, now rearrange it, so you will get this formula. Now what is the unit of number of moles? Moles. And the number of kg of solvent, so mole per kg. This would be the unit of molarity. So what would be the unit of molarity? Mole per kg. Mole kg having power minus 1, or simply is represented by a small m. So this is the unit of molarity. So now next I'll discuss normality, that is represented by capital N. Nowadays it is not used much. Generally in most of the cases we are using molarity or molality. Normality very rarely used nowadays. Okay, even then you should discuss it. So normality is what? Everywhere what is written? The number of moles of the solid. Here what is? Number of gram equivalent of the solid. Number of gram equivalent of the solute present in 1000 ml or 1 liter of solution. In case of molarity, number of moles of solute present in 1 liter or 1000 ml of solution. Here
the number of gram equivalent of solute present in 1000 ml or 1 liter of the solution. So normality, which is represented by capital N. So formula is number of gram equivalent divided by number of solution, number of volume of solution, sorry, volume of solution in liter, number of gram equivalent by volume of solution in liter. This is the case. So now how to find out the number of equivalent? Again, we'll take the actual mass of the solution in gram, and it would be divided by the gram equivalent mass of the solute. So when the actual mass of the solute divided by molar mass, then it gives us number of moles. But when the actual mass of solute divided by gram equivalent mass of the solute, then it will give us number of gram equivalent. Number of gram equivalent. And the volume of solution in liter would be replaced by volume of solution in ml divided by 1000. When ml is divided by 1000, it becomes liter. So that's why we have made an arrangement like this. Okay, why we have taken the gram or 1000? Because in laboratory we generally take solutions in ml, and we take in a gram, not in kg. So that is why we have arranged the formula in that way. So finally you are getting this formula after rearrangement. Now what is normality? Number of gram equivalent. So it is a gram equivalent at the top, at the bottom, that means at denominator, it is volume of solution in liter. So gram equivalent per liter would be the unit of normality. So what is the unit of normality? Gram equivalent per liter, or gram equivalent liter inverse, or simply it is represented by capital N. Capital N means gram equivalent per liter. Now the question arises, how to find out the gram equivalent? We know the molar mass, we know actual mass would be given in the question. So how to get the gram equivalent mass? So there are method to find out the gram equivalent mass of substance. First of all, if you have equivalent weight of the mass, or gram equivalent of the element, if the equivalent weight is expressed in mass, then it is called gram equivalent. If the equivalent weight of the compound expressed in, if the equivalent weight of the compound is expressed in gram, then it is called equivalent gram equivalent mass. So how to find out the equivalent weight of the element? Molar mass divided by valency. Molar mass divided by valency, then it will give you the equivalent weight of element. Like take the example. Now see, sodium. What is the valency of sodium? So equivalent weight of the sodium would be 23/1. So it will be same. Equivalent weight as well as molar mass, both are same. Now magnesium, its valency is 2. Atomic mass of magnesium 24 divided by 2. So it equal to 12. So 12 is the equivalent mass of magnesium. These are the way you can find out the equivalent weight of element. Now, so molar mass divided by valency. Now what is the equivalent weight of anything? You can find out equivalent weight of anything. Like we have to find out the equivalent weight of oxygen. So it will be, so what is this? What is the valency? -2. So what would be the equivalent weight of oxygen? 16 divided by 2 equal to 8. Equivalent weight of oxygen. So these are the way you can find out the equivalent weight of the element. Now, we have to find out the equivalent weight of the compound which contains H, like HCl. Equivalent weight of HCl, we have to find out. Gram equivalent mass of HCl, we have to find out. So, first molar mass would be divided by the number of replaceable H plus ion. Here you have got the H plus ion. How many H plus ion is here? 1. So what is the 1 plus 35.5? It is the molar mass of HCl divided by 1. It would be 36.5. Now I have to find out the equivalent mass of H2SO4, sulfuric acid. Now what would be the molar mass of sulfuric acid? For hydrogen it is 2, for sulfur it is 32, for oxygen it is 64. How many replaceable hydrogen is there? How many H plus ion is there? 2. So that's why it should be divided by 2. So in this way we can find out the equivalent weight of acid. Now we have to find out the equivalent weight of base. How to find out the equivalent weight of base? Suppose that we have to find out the equivalent weight of sodium hydroxide. Then what we will do? Molar mass will be divided by number of replaceable hydroxyl ion. This is the OH group. Divided by how many OH group? 1. So this will be the equivalent weight. Now, magnesium hydroxide, MgOH hold 2. So how many replaceable hydrogen is 2? So molar mass of magnesium hydroxide will be taken and divided by 2. Here it will be molar mass. Calculate it yourself. Molar mass of magnesium hydroxide will be taken up and it will be divided by 2. So like that we have to find out the equivalent to H of acid and base we have learnt. Now there will be situation where there is no H plus and OH minus in a particular compound. Then how the reaction will take place? How we will find out? Then we should carry out a reaction and we will find how many hydrogen it had replaced, how many hydrogen it had replaced. In that way, we have to find. So, what is important, or the third way, during the chemical reaction, when you balance it, after balancing, find out how many electrons are lost by a particular agent. So, molar mass would be divided by number of electrons lost, number of electron gained, or number of electron shared per mole. So how many number of electrons has undergone into a transaction, that you have to find out. So once you know the number of electron gained, lost or shared during the chemical reaction, then take the molar mass of that compound and divide it by the number of electron gained or shared or and you will be getting the equivalent weight. An equivalent weight is known as gram equivalent mass when it is expressed in gram. So equivalent weight is known as gram equivalent mass when it is expressed in gram. Okay, thank you.